So in my laboratory, we investigate proteins, the macromolecular machines of the cell. So our major goal is to study the structure and function of proteins, and our major discipline is structural biology. So in structural biology, our mantra is seeing is believing. So to understand how a protein functions, it is first necessary to visualize its structure. So along this line, our major technique is cryoelectron microscopy. The very first and crucial step is sample preparation. So for single particle analysis, we need the target protein in sufficient amounts and also in sufficient quality. For this reason, our first step is to produce the target protein. And therefore, we're using suitable cell factories, which can be yeast cells or bacteria, insect cells, or even very often human cells. So we have to keep ourselves happy in our cell cultures, yeah, to produce high amounts of the target protein. And then we use special protocols for the separation and the purification of the target complexes. So we separate the complexes either based on their size or affinity. And then after a final quality control step, the next step is to vitrify the sample for cryo-EM and high-resolution imaging in the electron microscope. We first apply a very small amount of the sample of the target protein on an EM grid. So we need only 4 microliters of the sample. Then in this special instrument that we call the plunger, we rapidly freeze the sample in liquid ethane at minus 180 degrees, actually. What happens there is that the target proteins are vitrified within a very thin amorphous ice layer, a layer that is clean and transparent to electrons. And then we can transfer the sample to our high-end electron microscope for high-resolution imaging. However, there is another important method that we name cryoelectron tomography. And for this method, we need an instrument named a cryofib. With the cryofib, we can cut a thin section of the cell, which we call a lamella. Then we can transfer again the sample into electron microscope. And this is in this case like opening a window in the cell of interest. Now we are able to visualize individual proteins, macromolecular machines directly in the cell. So with cryo-EM, we obtain 3D reconstructions of the target proteins or even of regions within the cell. This allows us to obtain portraits of our target molecules up to atomic resolution. I've been in the field quite long, and this is quite astonishing because this opens really a new era in structural biology. We can now visualize every individual atom very often of the target complex, which in turn allows us to understand this macromolecular machine at molecular level of detail.